Hello, Simbet Salam, Shabbat Salam, family. Your brother, Lejepti, Johannes Will Emmanuel here again for another posting and just some more commentary about mostly the literary works in which we continue in our, you know, our Parsha overview studies. And of course, I caught the vid and the video log from Anawendem Rasi Adinos Teferi, of the Lion of Judah Society, Rastafari Sabbatical, here on YouTube. And again, another shout out to Wyndham Aras Ambesa Teferi of Armageddon Band and Sound. It's I think I did catch the posting from the brother where he posted where he was actually, you know, just en route. I think he was still actually, you know, looking for another copy of the Chumash from Sonsino or Sonchino. I'm not exactly sure still of the pronunciations, but of course, you know, I and I Wyndham and our Rebbe, he continues to, you know, expound more upon the Parsha, the Torah portion studies with other, you know, just layers of understanding from, you know, especially those not immediately within I and I own community, but from others who have, of course, studied and put forth their interpretations and more of what they found, you know, from ancient text. And I haven't myself found an immediate copy of Sonchino as of yet. I know there are still many hard copies available, you know, of course, on the eBay and Amazon, and more so other, you know, platforms in which you know, commerce and other things continue to go on. And of course, Wyndham Oche and Ehitoche, please, brothers and sisters, you know, if you can get a copy of those, please continue. But again, I have to mention that as brethren in this community of Rastafari Ethiopian Hebrew, Bet Israel, you know, that Christ Man, of course, thinks alike as always. And give thanks again to I and I brethren, Wyndham Yad, and of course Wyndham Rasan Besa for bringing that forward. And Rasan Besa, of course, had brought about another you know, suggestion, of course, going forward with the other teachings for the Torah portions in which ones and ones will come forward to, of course, read and recite verses from the Torah portions, especially on Discipleship Radio and the Blog Talk Radio, as we continue to grow and ones are, you know, coming forward. And I have to give thanks just on the outset for the Sistren, for our Woman's Wednesdays. Of course, I and I Sistren, Sister Emmanuel, Sistren Mary Rose Israel, and of course, I and I Sistren, Sister Salama Wheat, for bringing forth those suggestions and bringing the fruition to, you know, the readings of the Psalms for those certain days and the Samint and the Shabuah, and which Woman's Wednesdays happens to occur, and ones of course are seeking to bring out the Hebrew as well as the Ethiopic Amharic. So it's you know, such a good thing that ones are looking into these studies, because now we really will get a greater understanding of what, you know, we're reading, you know, not just from the English, but it will actually be interpreted once we actually have a command of these languages and these ancient tongues in which we spoke from a certain point in time. And, you know, again, I have to shout out to I and I brethren, Wyndham Rasan Besa, for that suggestion, because now ones and ones will be able to, you know, not only read and study, but they'll be able to hear, you know, other ones read those Torah portions. And of course, from the Sistren's side of it, you will hear the Psalms and the Proverbs and, you know, so on and so forth, or whatever selective readings we will have for that certain day to come forward. Because I definitely have noticed, and Wyndham Rasi Adinos, of course, has mentioned that, you know, hearing the word read, it takes on a different perspective once you're able to listen. And, of course, if ones and ones have the scriptures with them, you know, in front of them at that very moment when the scripture is being read, there's another sort of interpretation and, you know, just internal perspective that you gain once you have those scriptures read to you, because now it becomes another point of reference and another point in which you can interpret those scriptures and those lessons, and especially having them read from another, and you're able to just receptively listen and hear, you know, as the word says, Shema Yisrael, Yahweh Eloheinu, Yahweh Ahad. You know, that first commandment, of course, is to listen and to hear the word as it is spoken. And we mentioned so much about the Rhema word and the spoken word, in which it becomes such a, you know, a valiant point in which we are able, you know, to learn and grow as it goes forward. And of course, you know, just to make a connection with this, just from our own Ethiopic roots, and our own African history, you know, there's two, of course, perspectives when it comes to Torah law, or the halakha, as we would say. Ethiopically, the Higu Mengist, or the law of the kingdom, and the law of the Higu Oritu, or the law of the scripture. So it comes from the oral tradition, and of course the written tradition. So of course in many African, and I'm just using African, of course, as a placeholder for which ones would know as of today, you know, those of African descent, so on and so forth. You know, you have this tradition in which you have many who were of the scribe's position, and upholding certain traditions, especially in culture, and just really relaying the other teachings from one generation to the next, as a scribe would do, and of course sealing these texts and these writings up, you know, for them to be passed down through generation. And of course the other side of, you know, those traditions would come in oral tradition, in which the stories were continuously told, you know, mostly in a you know, a venue in where you had many who would be able to come and sit and listen, and it was a really you know, big thing to have, or a really big event, and where you had many who would just come and listen to, you know, somewhat of a griot. Or you know, just as an example, you know, just a storyteller of some sort, you know, to keep these teachings going in a way that where ones and ones might not be able to afford a written copy, or weren't able to secure it in some sort of way, you know, what have you. The oral tradition would continue in its cultural perspective, you know, and also be relayed to the next generation as such. So, you know, this is just a balance beam, you should say, and which, you know, a recovery of such ancient traditions and ancient cultures, you know, have their rejuvenation or their reverberance. So I give so much thanks for I and I family who continue to study in these teachings, of course, and bring forward these messages, because this is another growing point, you know, and a stepping stone for I and I as we continue. And I want to make mention to the family that as I and I have not as of yet found a chumash of the Sonchino, you know, gathering in those religious Jews. And that's really the point in which I and I makes, is that these are the chumash, and most of these studies are coming from most of the religious Jews. And we have, you know, certain interpretations in which, of course, we can find that we agree on a lot of points. And, of course, we'll, you know, go a little further and just to search out the points in which we don't agree. And, of course, I'll put forward our own interpretations and our own perspectives on these literary works. And of course, Rasi Adinos, of course, has mentioned to I and I, as well as our I and I brethren on Windham Yasson, about bringing forward these publications. And from the time that the brethren had mentioned this, which was, you know, sometime in the past, it was, of course, during our last summit, to Amit, last year, I really started looking into the Chumash of other religious Jews, and I did come across many of the Torah portion scriptures, and these will be in a PDF or free shareware documents form, and I'll be posting those up to Rastafari Foundation, just so ones and ones can kind of become familiar with a certain portion or a type of Chumash. And this one actually comes from the Chabad Lubavitcher Jewish gatherings. So, and I think, and I have to recheck the documents again, but I'm pretty sure that they're coming out of the Brooklyn area as well. I'm pretty sure they're from the Crown Heights. Crown Heights area definitely has a large community. Mostly out of Eastern Parkway. I think that's the Kehot publication. But just from the PDF free shareware documents that INI has, it seems that they also have a publication unit or a publishing office out in the California area. So there's you know, much works that has been put forward from the Chabad Lubavitcher community of Orthodox or Hasidim, and the religious Jews or the Orthodox Jews of that community. And we also will, of course, seek to make those available for study and reference, just to get ones and ones familiar with those, you know, publications and interpretations of the scripture, just to learn and grow and get to practice and find more within, you know, these study portions that we have. And of course, as the brethren had mentioned, you know, I find it, you know, very humorous myself, you know, just looking through some of the Torah portions that I had put forth from the Chumash of Sonchino, that of course they have the original tongue of the languages all placed in order, and the orderly fashion of the readings, just as the eye was going through them. And I had mentioned a lot to many others that, of course, there's always a difference between the biblical Hebrew and modern Hebrew from what we know today. So, I mean, just not to be so anal about the point, but it's just, you know, just putting forward the truth about these scriptures and how, you know, they've been co-opted and, you know, first studied. They've been first studied and, you know, of course, scrutinized, you know, to the teeth, you know, just to say. But, you know, before there can come a corruption, there has to first come a learned command. You know, they have to really gain a great understanding over the original text before they can actually seek to, you know, disrupt the, of course, original line and the, you know, purpose of what the scriptures and the ancient text and, you know, these traditions and cultures, you know, had sought to put forward. So they have shown that they have definitely learned extensively to the point to where now they're able to interpret these scriptures and put forth their own interpretations as such. So I did take note of that. But of course, this is what we continuously study for, and of course to, you know, rejuvenate and resurrect, you know, our original lineage and our heritage, of course, in Christos Jesus, Yehoshua Moshiach. But I give thanks, our family, for putting that forward. And you know, I and I, of course, will seek to do I and I's part and just making sure that the family is familiarized with a lot of the text and the language, of course, as much as I am able, Yah willing. So we'll continue in putting these things forward, and hopefully ones and ones will be able to, you know, take that time and make that time to,
you know, continuously study and gather as much information as they can, you know, so that they, of course, can put forward their interpretations intelligently and, of course, honorably. So, again, I mentioned that for the I family. And, of course, you can visit Rastafari Groundation periodically. And I and I, of course, will be putting forward those free shareware documents, or at least the ones that I have as of this moment. And, you know, please get a download. And if you haven't, of course, been able to log on to Rastafari Groundation, be sure to, you know, visit the contacts page and get yourself connected with I&I family so that you, of course, can come in, learn and grow and share in this gathering. And I bid the I shalom here on this first day. And much peace within the heart, home, and mind as the eye goes forward throughout the rest of the Samint, the Shabua. And this is your brother again signing off, your brother Lidji FD, Yifdeya, Johannes Welde Emmanuel. Shalom.